Prime Minister, thank you. It's Tim Ferguson with Forbes. All around you in Southeast Asia and South Asia, and even in your own city-state, there is a mixed record with regard to popular democracy in recent years. Could you speak to the fate and future of popular democracy in this region?
I think it's a slogan. If you read some of the Western newspapers, I don't count Forbes, when you say pro-democracy, by definition, that's a good thing. Right. But if you look at the countries in Asia, you will know that these are complicated countries and they work in different ways. And even when you have elections, the power structure, the politics, the government functions in very different ways in these different countries. In Thailand, you have elections, but the king plays a critical role, the military plays a critical role, sometimes overtly. It has been so for a long time. If you look at India, they have a democracy. It functions in terms of getting a new government in place every now and again, but in terms of addressing fundamental challenges which a country faces, it makes it harder to do than perhaps is the case in China. If you look at China, they have no elections, but that doesn't mean they don't have the problems of having a government which is legitimate, which is functioning well, and which is subject to checks and balances. If you look at Singapore, we have elections, we have a parliament, we have an elected government. And yet, if you ask whether that is a formula which will automatically yield a good government and a successful country for the next 50 years, nobody can say. It depends on the people, it depends on the values of the society, it depends on the quality of the leaders and the connection between the leadership and the population. So I think each country has to find its own way forward. I don't think there's salvation in saying we need more democracy and that will make these countries prosper. And Hong Kong is just one of the cases in point.